right for you. We love a custom build. American Family Insurance. Insure carefully, dream fearlessly. Get a quote and find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
When it comes to security for your home and family, you want a winner. And we found one when we placed our trust with J&K Security Solutions. This is Greg Gard. Kim and Jeff hit the game-winning shot for us with the Control 4 home technology system. Home or away, from our smartphones, we can open the garage door, dim the lights, turn on the TV, as well as arm the security system. That's convenience as well as peace of mind. Let J&K Security Solutions do for your home or business like they've done for us. Call 255-5799 or online at jksecurity.com.
One call, that's all. It's not just a slogan, but a way of life at Gruberg Law Offices. If you've been injured, call our team today. We've represented tens of thousands of injured Wisconsinites for well over 30 years. Trust Wisconsin's own Gruberg Law Offices. One call, that's all.
The GRB Rays have established themselves as one of the top baseball programs in the Midwest and the country. GRB Academy offers training programs for players of all ages and skill levels. Learn from some of the best baseball coaches in the area and find the program that fits your training goals and your schedule. Spots are filling up fast, so visit grbacademy.com to sign up now. That's grbacademy.com. GRB Academy, baseball for the serious player.
Whether you're an artist playing accountant, a barista trying to be a bean counter, or a student just looking to get started, the UW Credit Union app lets you be free to be you. With free credit scores, free online bill pay, and the ability to send money to friends. Because with fewer fees, you can do more of what you love. UW Credit Union, here for every you. Join today at uwcu.org. Federally insured by NCUA.
Children's Theatre Madison presents Madison's favorite holiday tradition, A Christmas Carol. A celebration that sheds a warm glow on the gracious spirit of the holiday.
Hi.
Transport it back to the...
Can I talk to you?
Watch Scrooge embrace the true meaning of Christmas. A Christmas Carol will be live in the historic Capitol Theatre at the Overture Center December 9th through December 23rd. Get your tickets today at ctmtheater.org. That's ctmtheater.org.
Big trailers and big opportunity. Since 1962, Stoughton Trailers has been a family-owned and operated business. With competitive wages and excellent benefits, plus growth and advancement opportunities, Stoughton Trailers is an exciting place to grow your career. Join the collaboration, innovation, and dynamic team atmosphere at Stoughton Trailers. With positions now open in production, operations, finance, sales, engineering, supply chain, and more, go to stojobs.com to apply today. Stoughton Trailers, big trailers, big opportunity.
This is the 608 Basketball Tournament on ESPN Madison and Wisconsin On Demand.
When I'm gone, I'm never really gone. You think you're moving on, but it won't be for long. You'll see when I'm gone, I'm never really gone. You think you're moving on, but no one's gonna feel like. Thought it would be...
And I think Verona can match that. Number two, press and push the pace. They saw last night what the pace was like, right, when they played Northville, Lakeville North. Yeah. And that was pushing the pace on steroids. And then move the ball on offense. They'd be able to find the open man. And Trey Poteet driving the lane, and also Murph. And then for Onalaska, for them last night, it was keep Knippel. Well, they got to keep Drew Murphy in line. He had 47 points a couple weeks ago. Number two is rebound well and hold Verona to the one shot. And also good transition. No easy baskets. Trey Poteet and, as we saw last night, Cameron Williams had a really good game attacking the rim.
Yeah,
so
we're
going to have to watch him snaking down there for a couple easy ones.
Let's go take a 90-second break. When we come back, it's the 608 basketball tournament consolation game between Verona and Onalaska. That's next right here on 100.5 ESPN.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit celebrationsentertainment.com. That's celebrationsentertainment.com.
How much does it cost to talk to Gruber Losses after a serious crash? It's free. Yes, free. As in, it won't cost you anything to speak with us. Not sure if you have a case? Call our team at Gruber Losses today. Your first call and your first consultation are always free. And you'll never pay us a fee until we win your case. If you've been seriously injured, call Gruber Losses. One call, that's all.
Every Thursday this football season, huddle up for the Great Dane Huddle, live from the Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company.
It was awful. The defense didn't come to play. Special teams, the timing on the offense was off.
I mean, it's hard to win the national football
game. It is. It is very hard.
All that being said, this entire season rides on one position and one name, and that's Jordan Love.
The Great Dane Huddle with Alex Stroff, Tarek Salem, and Derek Engler. Thursdays at 6 on 100.5 ESPN.
Since 1956, Holman Lindsay Paints has been making paint in Wisconsin for Wisconsin. Because of their commitment to making great paint for Wisconsinites, Holman Lindsay has grown over the years to 26 locations in this great state. Headquarters in Sun Prairie with a state-of-the-art facility, Holman Lindsay has the paints you need to make your job better. From do-it-yourself to professional, Holman Lindsay has paint for everyone. Visit one of their local locations today in Madison, Sun Prairie, Middleton, and Janesville.
Life has its moments, times to remember and share. Mark the moment with jewelry from us, John Hayes or Goodman Jewelers. Make the beauty of your purchase match the beauty of the moment. For over 90 years, Goodman Jewelers has been providing sparkle to Madison. We can help you preserve a lifetime of memories with that special gift during this special season. Goodman Jewelers at 220 State Street, the Diamond Store of Madison.
The best is at Goodman's.
2023 is a very special year for Goodman's Jewelers. We're celebrating 90 years of serving the greater Madison area. John Hayes for Goodman's Jewelers. Needless to say, that's a long time and a lot of great memories working with you, our customers. During these nine decades, we've never deviated from our pledge to you, which is earning your trust, delivering top-notch service, and a selection that's second to none. Discover firsthand why Goodman's Jewelers is truly a destination worth reaching. 220 State Street, GoodmansJewelers.com.
The best is at Goodman's.
Get ready to tip off the 608 basketball tournament consolation game here from Madison. Alongside Dennis Semrau, Alex Stroff on hand with you courtside. As Verona, the Wildcats, get ready to take on Onalaska, the Hilltoppers, in this consolation game. How did we get here? Verona lost in semifinal number two last night to Lakeville North of Minnesota. A final of 105-74, Dennis. 74 in a high school hoops game isn't half bad, except when you allow 105.
Yeah, that's right. Wisconsin Lutheran only scored 77 last night. They got to win.
Absolutely. And Wisconsin Lutheran beating Onalaska in semifinal number one yesterday, a final, as Dennis mentioned, 77-61 for the Hilltoppers. These two teams will go toe-to-toe, looking to take a third-place finish in the third annual 608 basketball tournament here at Madison College. Packed house here at Madison College. What an attendance outing here on this fine Saturday. Game 2 of 4 on the slate today. And I don't know if we're going to top the last one, a double overtime win for Oshkosh North over Stoughton, a final of 86-84 in showcase game number one of two today. Onalaska wins the tip ball, and we are underway. But how about a steal right out the gates for Cameron Williams? Goes up hard, unable to lay it in, though.
He was trying to dunk it, dunked it off the rim.
Yeah, that's not ideal. Back the other way now for Onalaska on the offensive end. In the corner is Skifton. Bounce pass inside to Isaac Skemp, and that's stolen away by Verona. Back the other way we go, just 30 seconds in. Bennett Buss will bring it up. He'll cross over and set things up for the Wildcats offense. Working against Noah Chenault. Top of the key now, Drew Murphy, averaging over 25 points per game this season, his junior campaign. Ball at the top of the key, swings the elbows, dribbles at the free throw line, poked away on the ground, stolen away by Ian Kowal of Onalaska, and Adam Skifton, the All-State quarterback selection by the Associated Press, will bring it up for the Hilltoppers. Top of the key now, Kowal.
Three turnovers and a missed dunk. That's how we start the game.
1 minute in, that's what we got. How about this for Evan Anderson driving the baseline, misses the layup underneath the hoop. And back the Verona direction now as they get it quickly past the 10-second line. And another turnover. Stolen away by Skifton for Onalaska. Chenault holds it high, top of the key, kicks to the right corner. Three ball up, rattles out, no good. Offensive rebound though for Kowal, who missed the shot, got his own rebound. And back to the top of the key again, stolen away by Cameron Williams of Verona. He goes up strong left side, off the glass, no good. Follow up, Poteet, no good. And rebounded by Onalaska. 90 seconds in, we are scoreless in this consolation game. 0-0 between Verona and Onalaska.
Yeah, we saw a lot of good offensive rebounding for Verona. We saw that on this end here.
Working it around the circle are the Hilltoppers. Top of the key, Anderson, the South Dakota commit. Works against Drew Murphy. Crosses over right wing, still hanging onto it. Kicks it, skips it, left corner. Pump fake, and now the high arcing three-point shot goes down for Isaac Skemp. First bucket of this one. How about Isaac Skemp yesterday in the semifinal loss to Wisconsin Lutheran? 24 points a season high for him.
Yeah, known for his three-point shooting in the past. This year, a little bit more inside-outside. Last night, 3-9 for three-point range.
Had kind of an awkward poke away there in the in the Verona offensive corner. It'll stay with the Wildcats, as I believe it was Evan Anderson in there poking it away in the right corner. Here's the inbound now for Verona. Mason Sherry has checked in. He'll inbound. Bennett Buss, top of the key, works left hand, right up the middle of the lane, right side, layup with the right hand, no good. Rebound pulled away by Onalaska and Isaac Skemp. He works it up the middle of the court, past the 10-second line, skips it left corner now. Skifton hands it off in the left corner to Kowal. Back top of the key now, Chenault. Chenault crosses over, working against Trey Poteet. Hands off and now poked away by Sherry. Now picked back up by Skifton. Wide open look for Skemp on the left wing. Bingo bango for Isaac Skemp, his second triple of the game. Gives Onalaska an early 6-0 lead. 15-19 to play in the first half as Trey Poteet brings it inside, kicks it outside right wing for Mason Sherry, a triple up, no good, rebound quickly, and by Evan Anderson, who quickly transitions, works it right side, now inside the paint, spinning off the glass, no good, rebound Bennett Buss of Verona, and here come the Wildcats. Skip pass down low for Poteet on the left block, floats it up off the back of the iron, no good, rebound Onalaska. And Onalaska early, Dennis, setting the tone here in this one. Skemp on the right wing, working against Sherry. Left-handed pass goes left side. Now Chenault works it with the right hand. Right to center court, top of the key, drives inside. Tipped in the air, caught in the left corner by Skemp. Skemp drives baseline, kicks right corner for Kowal. Three ball is up, no good off the back of the rim. Rebound, high arcing rebound from Drew Murphy, who speeds the other way into the lane, right block. He's called for a charge.
Looked like a running back trying to put that shoulder down to run through the tackle, and in this case ran through the defender and got charged with the offensive foul.
First foul of the game brings the first timeout of the game. We'll take a 30-second timeout right alongside with him. You're listening to Zimbra Conda's presentation of Prep Mania in the 608 basketball tournament.
The GRB Rays have established themselves as one of the top baseball programs in the Midwest and the country. GRB Academy offers training programs for players of all ages and skill levels. Learn from some of the best baseball coaches in the area and find the program that fits your training goals and your schedule. Spots are filling up fast, so visit grbacademy.com to sign up now. That's grbacademy.com. GRB Academy, baseball for the serious player.
Me Supercondas presentation of Prep Mania in the 608 basketball tournament rolls on live from Madison College. In the consolation game between Verona and Onalaska, all Hilltoppers early, 6-0 with 14:22 to play in the first half. Alongside Dennis Semrau, I'm Alex Strofe with you. Courtside at Madison College, Onalaska basketball and a 6-0 lead. Chenault brings it up, works it with the left hand, now looks left, passes right. Skip comes cutting up to the right wing, he catches now. Skips it left corner for Skifton, back top of the key. Kowal now right corner. Anderson drives with the left hand against Drew Murphy, hands it back top of the key. Kowal now a shot from the left wing by Skemp, airballs it and goes out of bounds. We'll go back the direction of the Wildcats.
We were just double checking a number here. Last night, Kamar Bridges Miller was 55. We didn't have a zero. That's who he is today.
They were wearing the orange jerseys last night. Now the white
jerseys today. Yeah. I think it's baseball. Baseball that switches basketball occasionally.
Occasionally.
I like football. They're the same number, right?
One of those cases indeed. Amari Phillips has checked in at the point guard for Verona for the first time tonight as Bridges Miller goes underneath for Sherry. Layup. Toilet bowl twice, but eventually fell for Mason Sherry. His first bucket and Verona's first bucket of the night. Back the other way, quick drive and a long two from the corner for Skemp, no good, rebounded eventually by Buss of Verona, and here come the Wildcats in transition. Underneath is Sherry, fades away from the left block, no good, got his own rebound, shot it again, missed it long that time, rebounded by Anderson of Onalaska.
Buss, the smallest guy on the floor, he gets more offensive rebounds.
Yeah, I've noticed
last that. Last night he had a great night crashing the boards, there he snuck back, dipped back door and got that last one.
Goes off the knee of an Onalaska player, actually not off the knee of a Verona player, rather, will stay with Onalaska. Will Stremlo was checked out, was in there quickly, looks like he has a nosebleed, he's got a 10-2 on the sideline briefly, as Onalaska goes back to work offensively. Underneath, a nice pivot by Anderson, loses the ball, busts in there to disrupt, and eventually stolen away by Verona. Bridges Miller underneath for Amari Phillips, who's underneath the basket. Bounce pass outside, stolen away by Anderson. And slowing down the pace now is Anderson, bringing it across the 10-second line, holds it high atop the key. Crosses over, splits the defenders up, and in, no underhand, missed it barely. Circus shot there from Evan Anderson, but unable to get it to fall. Jump ball called, we'll go back to Verona. 6-2 remains the score.
We got three guys on that one, trying to decide who to give the rebound to. Give it to the big guy, the guy that pulled it away. That was 24 Sherry on that one.
Stremlo checks back in following the bloody nose, and he will bounce pass it on the inbound to Bennett Buss, who will bring it up for Verona.
Stremlo, good-looking freshman there with the ball in the corner.
Yeah, and he gets it and passes inside for Murphy, who floats one up from the left block. No good. Rebound by Skemp of Onalaska. Hilltoppers dominating the boards here early, Dennis, specifically on the defensive end.
Yeah, one of the keys, they love to rebound and hold a bonus to one shot, and that's what they're doing.
Anderson goes behind the back, working against Bennett Buss, about 3 feet above the key. Now works it inside, kicks it outside for Brody Mitchell, who's checked in. Pass across the way, but a foul called off ball. A shoe came off, in fact. I believe that's Brody Mitchell would be called for the foul, and it is. His shoe came off in the midst of an offensive foul. Love it.
I like it. One foul each, and we've played 6.5 minutes. Let's keep it that way.
Roll, all the way deep, all the way down, all the way down. 6-2 your score. Onalaska leads Verona in the 6-0-8 basketball tournament consolation game. Here's a long three for Sherry. The follow-up by Drew Murphy, good.
Kind of over the back, just up, didn't block him out, and he tipped it in.
But not an illegal over the back.
No. Just jumped over, and so we can get your hands up and get that body on there. Did not. Murphy took advantage of it.
Skemp brings it in the lane, floats one up, airballed it. Offensive rebound, though, good for Steiner. He kicks it to the left corner, an open look for Jack Smith. That's no good. Here's Drew Murphy on the breakaway. Murphy up and unable to lay it in on the finger roll.
Murph, got to finish that off the glass. I think he was trying to put it just over the edge of the rim. And
Drew Murphy listed at 6'6", Dennis. He's got to throw that thing down. Show a little aggression here. Tie this game up. 6-4 the score. Onalaska still in front with the basketball. Skep drives the baseline. Spins. Kicks back up for Smith. Smith goes right side. Stolen away by Stremlo. Kicks it forward for Bridges Miller. Unable to reel it in. Now holds it in the left corner. Bridges Miller, bounce pass left block for Murphy. Murphy spins, goes up, blocked, and a jump ball called. It was Broden Steiner there in defense. Nicely done by Steiner. Junior forward in defense of the 6 foot six Drew Murphy.
Yep, Murphy coming out here.
And number 22
is Bodeo. Oh, got that.
Say that again.
Bodeo. Doesn't look like it, but that's what Kirchhoff says, Bodeo. I confirmed it with him on the way out last night.
All right, well,
we're two
you.
Of the last people to leave.
Who were you talking to last night?
Talking to a couple of coaches. Actually, my two Middleton guys.
Okay. Tie up there. Foul going to be called. A little bit of a weird passing instance. That foul goes against Verona and Cameron Williams. It's his first, second on the Wildcats.
And a little photo op with Garlock and Isaac Oliver. Dean's kid that you're here to watch. Okay. Oh, a little action right in front of us.
It's yeah, nice. The inbound from Skifton, defended by Stremlo, will inbound it right in front of us.
I see how I work in the scores table. You hear everything down
yeah,
there.
Yeah, you sure do. Just don't say the F word, please. We're on FCC-regulated airwaves. Inbound to Kowal with 10.5 to play in the first half. Works the left side, spins against Bodeo. Oh, boy, the pass to Anderson blocked away by Bridges Miller. Picked up by Williams of Verona. Quickly the other way. Bus in the right wing. Kicks to the right corner for Williams. Oh boy, tiptoeing that out of bounds line. Now drives the baseline, floats one up, no good. Slapped away by Smith and rebounded by Onalaska. Here comes Skifton in transition on the right wing. Gives it top of the key, Jack Smith. Kicks left side, Kowal now the corner for Anderson, up for three, got it to go. Evan Anderson, good from 3-point range.
Kept him shut out almost 9 minutes here.
Yeah, he's their best scorer, averaging over 18 points per game, headed to South Dakota next year. Big triple for him, makes it a 9-4 lead for the Hilltoppers. 9:37 to play in this first half.
All three buckets, three-pointers, three different points. Actually, Skimp's got two, and now Anderson one.
Cameron Williams steps inside the arc, knocks down the long two-point shot from the left side. Nice shot by Cameron Williams, who had a team-high 24 in their loss to Lakeville North last night. Back the other way now, Broden Steiner underneath the basket. Misses the first, makes the second off the glass. Sometimes you just got to smooch it off the glass, right?
That's right.
Steiner's first bucket of the tournament. Halfway through this first half, driving the baseline is Kamar Bridges Miller. He stepped out of bounds. We'll go back on Alaska's way. A lot of turnovers early in this one, Dennis.
Can we say they're letting them play a little bit? This is a physical game. All these shots inside are contested. The guys are banging around. And you want points in the paint. There's no points. They're getting opportunities. Well, both teams are touching the post, but nothing is falling
Dennis,
down.
You always struggle with giving me credit. I don't know if you listen to my fist bumps with the referees and the officials prior to the game, but I said, let's have a fun one.
Yeah, okay.
Let them play a little bit, fellas. And they sure are doing that. 8:53 left, 11-6 on Alaska.
I forgot lead. About that. That's
yeah,
right.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Skip the crossover. Nice drive. Kicks right corner for Kowal. Anderson, oh boy, got tied up there with Williams. Good defense by Cameron Williams as Anderson goes to the floor.
Oh,
and on Alaska will use a timeout. Cameron Williams on the defensive side of the ball had a terrific offensive game last night. Showed what he can do on defense there. 8:39 to play in the first half. We'll take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zimbricata's presentation of Prep Mania in the 608 basketball tournament.
Mark Tauscher here for my friends at Buck and Honey's. Well, are you looking to celebrate Wisconsin hospitality this holiday season? Reserve a table or schedule a party at Buck and Honey's, a perennial Best of Madison Award winner with locations in Sun Prairie, Monona, Wanakee, and their new great spot out in Mount Horeb. They always take great care of me and my family, and they can't wait to take care of yours. Reservations go fast, so log on to buckandhoneys.com today. That's buckandhoneys.com. I'll see y'all at Buck and Honey's.
This is the 608 basketball tournament on ESPN Madison and Wisconsin On Demand.
608 consolation game, 8:39 to go in the first half. Onalaska leads Verona 11-6. Hilltoppers basketball, the inbound to Kowal. The smooth sophomore, son of the head coach Craig. Gives it off to Evan Anderson, the South Dakota commit. Steps inside the arc, fades away at the left elbow. Can't get it to go. Rattles out, rebound by Mason Sherry, who's back in for Verona. Sherry will bring it across the 10-second line. Works from right to left. Spins top of the key, hands off to Will Stremlo, the freshman. Back to Sherry now on the left wing. Sherry thinking, moving. Now will use his dribble left hand, drives a baseline. Nice move by Sherry. Kicks top of the key, Cameron Williams. Wide open for three.
Oh.
Yes, sir. Cameron Williams, good from downtown.
Count
5
it.
Points for him now. 9-11, Verona trails on Alaska with 7:55 to go in the first half. Skifton on the left wing, works against Stremlo. Goes between the legs, top of the key, now works left side. Now underneath to Anderson, who goes up on the left block. No good, offensive rebound. Steiner, who's fouled on the follow through. Steiner will go to the line, shooting two. Foul will go against Verona's Maddox. Bodeo. Sound that out together, Dennis. With 7:42 to play in the first half. 2-point on Alaska lead. Broden Steiner has the opportunity to make it three or four. He makes a three on the first one, makes the first. 3 points now for the junior, Broden Steiner. Second one, up and good. Both good from the line for Broden Steiner. And he will come out as Noah Chenault checks back in. Chenault, one of the best rebounders in this game, Dennis, averaging over 8 boards per contest.
Yeah, he's their point guard. He's got, he's had a couple ACLs coming in. This game resembles a Badger Conference game. First team to 50 wins. It's like a football game on court.
No doubt about that.
Another one.
Another miss and a rebound by Anderson on the Verona offensive side. Anderson works it forward. Skemp holds it on the right wing. Kicks right corner for Kowal. Three is up. Three is good. Ian Kowal's first bucket of the night. Hit a triple in the semifinal loss yesterday. Quickly matches his total from yesterday
makes
with that triple.
Makes dad happy. His dad, Coach Craig Kowal.
Head coach of Onalaska. Skipped and drives, and a foul called offensively as Stremlo Verona fell to the floor.
Taking the charge.
And you can see a little bit of blood on the lip of Stremlo. You can tell he's a freshman. He's still got braces. But he's not wearing a mouth guard. Credit to him. He's a tough one.
Oh, chip off the old block. Dad played for Bo Ryan, his sisters. Going to Iowa next year and watching her play last Saturday over at McFarland. Same way, on the floor, diving for loose balls, taking charges.
Chip off the old block. Tell me you were born in the 1980s, or that tell me you were born before the 1980s. Here's a three from Sherry. Offensive rebound long by Cameron Williams. Goes up left side and kisses it off the glass again. Cameron Williams has been the most impressive Verona player in this tournament, Dennis. No doubt about it. Both sides of the floor. Look at him right in front of us. Guarding Chenault. He's not letting him get anywhere. Cameron Williams locking it down defensively. Gets rid of it now. Skipped and hands it off to Anderson right wing. Anderson drives to the free throw line. And another charge called as the freshman Will Stremlo takes it.
And it's after Murphy took a shot to the face, started to walk away, and then Stremlo.
Now,
these guys are going to need a transfusion at halftime. But,
I'll tell you this, though, Dennis. How do you stay on the floor as a freshman? You play great defense. And Will Stremlo has taken two charges in this first half. Nicely done by the freshman. Buss will bring it up for the Wildcats. Looks underneath for Sherry on the right block. He takes one dribble, spins, goes left side of the hoop. Can't get it to go. Not enough mustard on that one. And now a tie up underneath. We'll go back the direction of Onalaska. Foul called against Mason Sherry.
No, we got another offensive foul going the other way.
We have 7 total fouls in this game. I think 5 of them have been offensive.
Yes.
Don't see that every day.
A few more. These guys are going to literally punch for punch.
6:08 to go in this first half of the 6:08 basketball tournament. Kowal with another triple from the left side. No good offensive rebound now by Chenault. Left corner again, Kowal for three. That one rattles out again. This time brought in by Verona. Poked away, though, and Verona eventually comes up with it. Here comes Buss right in front of us on the left side of the floor. Spinning on the left wing, hands to Stremlo. Takes one dribble to his right, now drives the lane, pulls up from the elbow. Off the back of the iron, no good. Rebound on Alaska. Skemp passes to Chenault. Chenault goes left side. Kowal again, open, thought about the three, didn't take it though. Gives it up to Skemp on the left wing. Skemp dribbles inside the arc, stops, 1 foot inside the arc, 1 foot outside. And they'll set things back up. Will Chenault, top of the key, gives it to Kowal right side. Skip pass left corner. Here's a three from Chenault. That one goes. Noah Chenault's first bucket of the night. Good from three-point land. Five threes now for Onalaska, hanging on to a 19-11 lead with 5 minutes to go in the first half.
Five of the six baskets.
Williams on the right elbow. Skips it left side for Sherry on the left block. He goes up with it strong, unable to get it to fall as Skemp again comes away with an Onalaska rebound. Skemp to Chenault. Another triple for Chenault. Yes, sir. Nothing but net for Noah Chenault. Back-to-back threes for him, and the lead is 11 for the Hilltoppers, 22-11.
Great feed off the fast break by Skemp. He's not hitting the threes, passing his teammate for one.
Bennett busts with a good drive. High off the glass, way too high as it went off the top of the hoop. And now a couple of subs. Kamar Bridges-Miller and Trey Poteet will check back in for Verona for Stremlo and Sherry.
There's so much contact now. You see when they're driving the lane, how hard they're forcing their shots, expecting the contact.
Ooh, nice pump fake by Kowal as he drives it inside the free throw line, kicks it back top of the key for Chenault. Rattles out, no good. Thought he was going to have three in a row.
Wanted a triple.
He sure did. Back the other way now. Cameron Williams for three. Yes, sir. Cameron Williams, second three, up to 10 points now. Leads all scorers. 22-14 on Alaska, still in front. As a pass went the direction of Kowal, Kamar Bridges, Miller stepped in front of it, just caught it, but he was out of bounds.
Now Williams is 10 of the 14 points, and he is looking very good on both ends of the court.
And here comes Williams, tracking down the inbound pass on the other end of the 10-second line. Now it's a 5-on-4 opportunity for Onalaska. Long three, no good. Offensive rebound. Skifton blocked away by Murphy, but a foul call. Believe that'll go against Kamar Bridges-Miller, and it will.
Yes.
It's his first, fifth on Verona. Only three fouls against Onalaska with 3:46 to play in the first half. Adam Skifton goes to the line now. Averages about 12 points per game. Gets his first of this one on the first free throw make. Skifton, Dennis, a first team all-state quarterback selection by your team at the Associated Press.
He was on my ballot.
Pretty good season for him?
Yes, very good season.
Is very good an understatement if you're the top quarterback in the state? Brilliant
season. Right there. And the other all-state quarterback, second teamer, was Casey Helgeson from Monroe-Barneville.
And we've seen him a few times, so Skifton must have been real darn good. Missed the second, remains a nine-point game, 23-14, 3:38 to go in the first half. Hold it. Kamar Bridges-Miller holds on the right wing, gives it top of the key to Drew Murphy. Now left corner, here's a three-point shot for Verona. That one rattles up, no good from Poteet, but offensive rebound by Bridges-Miller. Missed the follow-up, get another board for Kamar Bridges-Miller. Just dancing underneath the hoop, misses again. That one finally brought in by Onalaska and Evan Anderson. Way to stick with it by Kamar Bridges-Miller, but would have liked a point or two.
They just cannot buy a basket inside. Offensive rebounding, they're pounding the glass, they're doing everything they can except getting. Must be a cover on the basket, that's all I can think about.
Yeah, must be glass or something because I can't see it, but nonetheless. Under 3 minutes to play in the first half, Anderson holds top of the key, spins at the left elbow. Now pump fakes the free throw line, floats forward, no good. Rebound Trey Poteet of Verona. Back the other way, Poteet's pass deflected into the stands, will stay with Verona.
There's no star respect here today. Murphy and Anderson are taking their shots. Every shot is contested. Every shot, they're being bodied up, being physical. Murphy on one end got hit, got punched in the face. I think it was an inadvertent elbow, but still. You got to be tough to play out here today.
They're grinding this one away. We just watched a double overtime thriller, a win by Oshkosh North over Stoughton in two overtimes to kick off today's action at the 608 basketball tournament. This is the consolation, third place game between these two teams, Verona and Onalaska. Cameron Williams holds at the free throw line, spinning, cuts, passes to a cutting Bennett Buss underneath. The ball is loose. Stremlo on the floor on his knees at the left block. Bounce pass top of the key. Cameron Williams crosses over to the rim. Oh. Throws it down with authority. Cameron Williams. My goodness. Cuts that lead to 7. 23-16 now. As Cameron Williams setting the tone. He's got 12 of Verona's 16. Anderson underneath for Onalaska, goes up hard, falls to the floor, gets it to fall. Back the other way now, Stremlo drives. I think he'll be called, excuse me. The defense will be called for blocking foul as Stremlo tried to go up pretty far up. Oh, it would have been a long layup or floater, but he will go to the line nonetheless. Foul goes against Onalaska's Jack Smith. That's his first. Only the fourth against Onalaska. And now Cottrell Robinson, the head coach of Verona, in front of us, trying to tell Stremlo, Eurostep with it when you're coming off the wing like that. Full demonstration from the animated Cottrell Robinson, one of the best coaches in the area, his second year at Verona. And a foul called again as Stremlo draws another one. That one will go against Chenault. Also his first. So each team with five fouls now. It's a 9-point Onalaska lead, 25-16, a minute 47 to go in the first half of action. We're being a 9-point game, Dennis. It feels a lot closer. These two teams battling back and forth. Stremlo for three off the inbound. Shoots it long. Off the back side of the rim, no good. Rebound on Alaska back the other way. Here's Skemp driving against Stremlo on the baseline. Kicks back outside left wing for Chenault. Now right corner, here's an open look. Up, no good. Shot it long. Did Evan Anderson. Cameron Williams quickly in transition. Spins, lost the ball. Anderson poked it from behind him. And now we got 4-on-3 for Verona, or excuse me, for Onalaska against Verona. And a foul called against Kamar Bridges Miller. That'll be his second.
Verona foul on number 0, Kamar Bridges Miller, his second.
Isaac Skemp will go to the line, shooting two with a 9-point lead. He has 6 points here. Two triples early on in this one for Isaac Skemp. 24 points in the semifinal loss to Wisconsin Lutheran yesterday as he misses the first free throw. Shot it a little long. Sherry Miller will check out. Yep, yeah, Sherry back in for him.
Mr. Physical.
Is that how we describe Sherry?
Yes.
Noted.
6'6 senior forward. Getting his money's worth out there.
Skemp's second free throw good. Extends the lead to 10. 26-16, a minute 18 to go in the first half. Back the other way now for Verona. Stremlo holds it high over his head on the right wing. Goes inside to Mr. Physical Mason Sherry. Back out as Stremlo drives the baseline. And a foul again called. As that's the third foul in the last 3 minutes that Stremlo has drawn. This one will go against Chenault. It's his second. First Onalaska player with two fouls in this one. A minute 8 to go in the first half. As Kowal will check back in for Chenault.
Number 12, Ian Cole.
I think the reason it's a 10-point deficit, but Verona's getting so many looks inside. Seems like the score should be a lot closer.
Drew Murphy on the inbound turnaround jumper from about 4 feet. No good off the front of the iron. Onalaska will pull it away, takes it across the 10-second line, does Evan Anderson with a minute to play in this first half. Anderson working against Cameron Williams. Picked up his dribble, but 6 feet above the arc, but able to get rid of it left side. Skemp now steps inside the three-point arc, working against Stremlo at the left elbow. Kicks outside to Skifton for three. Oh. Got it to go, Adam Skifton.
Adam Skifton, 3 points.
13-point lead, the largest of this one. 29-16, 35 to go in the first half. Left side, Williams. Williams back top of the key for Bennett. Buss, who pulls a long triple. That goes off the front of the rim, no good. Offensive rebound, Cameron Williams spinning, throws one up, no good. Again gets his rebound, though. Swings the elbows, goes back up. Cameron Williams and one. Got it to go. Cameron Williams, a big reason. Verona is within 11 points, could make it 10 on the and one conversion here. 29-18 the score.
14 of their 18 points, ouch.
Could be 15 of 19 with a make here for number 15, Cameron Williams. Had 24 last night in the semifinal loss to Lakeville North as he cashes the free throw and one conversion for Cameron Williams. I'll just say this, not to jinx him. Hello, all tournament team.
Yes, you like to think.
Less than 10 seconds now. Evan Anderson taking his time, gets a screen, top of the key, works it left side. Stops at the elbow, pops back out. Skemp will pull the three as time expires. Air balls it, no good. 10-point game at half. On Alaska 29, Verona 19 as we go to the break. Coming up next, we've talked a lot about Will Stremlo. the freshman. We will hear from the older sister, Taylor Stremlo, one of this week's UW Credit Union Student Athletes of the Week, headed to Iowa next year to play some college hoops. We'll hear from Taylor Stremlo, this week's UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week. Coming up next, you're listening to Zimbra Conda's presentation of Prep Mania in the 608 basketball tournament.
Hi, it's Eric from Canopy Wealth Management. We're an independent, fee-based firm specializing in customized investment management, tax-aware wealth planning, and personalized client service. We're a steward along your financial journey because you deserve more than a run-of-the-mill experience. Canopy Wealth Management. Care, competence, clarity. It's not just a tagline. It's a promise. Go to canopy-wealth.com to get started today. That's canopy-wealth.com.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at two convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
For 30 years, Event Essentials has had copier printers from James Imaging Systems, your local business technology partner. Owner-President Kevin Hoffman.
I'm a local company, too. I'm just a one-location company in Dane County, so it is important that somebody's local.
James is not only local, but they've also been a 100% Wisconsin-owned and managed business technology company for over four decades.
They've been supportive of the community. They've been a good partner and advisor. Their support's been good.
James Imaging Systems, reliable document imaging technology, and even more reliable local support to always keep your business up and running.
It's just one less thing to worry about.
Kevin, as a 30-year James Imaging Systems customer, anything to say to others?
I would say James Imaging is a one-stop source for your office automation equipment.
For business technology, make your next stop James Imaging Systems. Call 608-221-3457. James Imaging Systems, your local business technology partner.
It's all about the green and gold and nonsense on Kyle, Brust, and Nortman.
If I'm wrong, I'll jump in Lake Michigan naked. I will.
No one's asking for the naked part. Yeah.
What? Why can't it be swimming trunks or shorts?
You really want? Is there something funny about watching something like blurred? Like if my butt was blurred and I was jumping in?
Kyle, Brust, and Nortman. Presented by Bud Light. Weekdays from 2 till 4 on 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
Big trucks can be intimidating. If you've been seriously injured in a truck crash, call Gruber Law Offices today. Trucking law can be extremely complicated. You don't want to take on the insurance company alone. Gruber Law Offices has the experience, the resources, and of course, the results. We know truck law. We know the rules and regulations. We know what it takes to win. Call Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at two convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
Big trailers and big opportunity. Since 1962, Stoughton Trailers has been a family-owned and operated business. With competitive wages and excellent benefits, plus growth and advancement opportunities, Stoughton Trailers is an exciting place to grow your career. Join the collaboration, innovation, and dynamic team atmosphere at Stoughton Trailers, with positions now open in production, operations, finance, sales, engineering, supply chain, and more. Go to stojobs.com to apply today. Stoughton Trailers, big trailers, big opportunity.
This is the 608 Basketball Tournament on ESPN Madison and Wisconsin On Demand.
Our ESPN Madison UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week, Taylor Stremlo, Verona Area High School, right?
Thank you.
We have to talk about the whole area. Well, first of all, congratulations. You'll be going out to Iowa to play basketball next year.
Thank you.
But we want to talk about right now. You're from a basketball family. Your dad played at Platteville for Bow, and your mom played at Butler, and you've got an older sister who's playing and younger siblings. What's it like to be a basketball family?
Like you said, everybody played, so it was constant competition growing up. I'd say I was born with a basketball in my hands. So from right away being a young kid, I got to play pretty much any sport I wanted to. My parents encouraged anything. They always just have worked to give me any opportunity that I wanted, let me try new things, always encouraged me to do what I want, let me be independent. They're hard workers, competitors, and just both really kind, genuine people.
Going to Iowa, saw the whole recruiting process. As much as the men's basketball team, Wisconsin, gets Minnesota, Iowa seems to get a lot of the best players from Wisconsin. You and Tegan Mullaney over at McFarland going to be teammates next year.
Yeah, I'm pumped up. I think it's pretty obvious they do a great job recruiting, and they're very genuine people, a well-established program. I mean, and there's so many awesome fans. The support there is evident. You see they sell out so many games, and on one of my visits, one of my unofficial visits, I met somebody like at a gas station, and they were like, oh, hey, aren't you committed? And I was like, yeah. So it's like,
they know you are.
Yeah, they know you, and I think that's awesome for women's basketball and for Iowa in general.
Now the next group, recruiting group, are you connected? How's that kind of going now that you've committed and you've officially signed?
We have a little group chat, and then we've also met on our official visit. We got to hang out. They flew in. One of our girls is from Oregon, so pretty far, really far. So she got to fly in and got to meet her. All hang out. That was awesome just to hang out with everybody. And then obviously Tegan's a little closer, so I've gotten to see her at more games. And it's been fun just getting to know everybody and following everybody's season so far.
And everyone knows who Caitlin Clark is.
Yeah.
What kind of inspiration has she been?
Yeah, I mean, she's been amazing. Just, you see it every game, every time she's on TV, just the impact she has on fans, on women's basketball in general. It's a craze that everybody wants a picture, a jersey, just to see her live in person, do what she does best. And I think that's so good for the sport and for women getting the recognition that they deserve.
Your whole high school career has been in this new high school with this incredible weight room here. What do you remember most about Verona Area High School when you leave?
I would just say the people. You know, I've grown up here my whole life. Got to watch Coach when she was in high school and you were spotlighting her. I just have so many vivid memories being a little girl, coming to their games, and even being eighth grade, seventh grade, you know, at the age there, you don't realize how big of a deal it is still to those girls, but just thinking it was such an awesome thing. And now getting in to be in that position where I get to have that influence on people, especially young girls, is really awesome.
Great. We're ESPN Madison, UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week. Taylor Stormwell, Verona Area High School. Mm-hmm. Hope you have a great senior year and congratulations.
Thanks so much, Dennis. Thanks.
Every event tells a story, from the first impression to the final moments. Have someone guide your guests through every chapter the way you want the story told. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With a strong presence, great voices, and an award-winning team, trust us to guide, direct, and inform your guests through all the different chapters of the day. For fun, memorable entertainment for any event, please visit us at celebrationsentertainment.com. That's celebrationsentertainment.com.
Life's better with an auto policy from American Family Insurance. No matter what dreams you're driving towards. That's because our expert agents will make you feel totally protected with the right auto coverage at the right price. You'll also save up to 23% when you bundle auto with home. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
At LASIK Plus, each one of our patients is unique, so we customize their journey to them.
I have a million questions about LASIK and a busy schedule.
All good. We offer free virtual consultations for just that reason.
I can't stand my contacts, but to be honest, I'm a little nervous.
We completely understand. We'll talk about treatment day, your surgeon, and what to expect.
I really need to stay within a certain budget.
We got you. LASIK Plus has financing options to get you where you need to be. From our free consultations to our patient app to our amazing staff and doctors, LASIK Plus is making your journey towards 20/20 vision all about you. Let's talk about your journey. Book your free virtual consultation at LASIK Plus today.
Right now at LASIK Plus, get 20% off LASIK in December. That can be over $900 off when treating both eyes with guaranteed financing. Visit MyLASIKOffer.com.
Must mention this promotion and be treated in December of 2023 to qualify. 20% off standard price of procedure cannot be combined with any other offers. Go to MyLASIKOffer.com for details.
It's December to remember at Metro Ford of Madison. Don't miss out on great offers like a rugged 2023 Ford F-150 for just 2.9% APR. For 66 months to qualified credit, $15.15 per 1,000 borrowed. Or the sleek 2023 Ford Edge for 0% APR for 66 months. Additionally, you'll receive a gift with the purchase of a new vehicle, 2 years no charge maintenance, a 4K TV, fee, $500 gift card, or first payment paid up to $500. All exclusive to Metro Ford of Madison.
Set your game plan for a new baseball season with a 2024 Brewers 4-Pack. Pick from four action-packed plan choices, each loaded with can't-miss Brewers games to fit your schedule and the best ticket prices, all available before single-game tickets are sold. Plus, when you buy a pair of 4-Packs, you'll get a limited-edition Brewers knit hat. Find the right plan for you today at brewers.com/4packs.
This is the 608 Basketball Tournament on ESPN Madison and Wisconsin On Demand.
Halftime over and done with. Getting ready for second half action of the 608 Basketball Tournament consolation game. On Alaska leads Verona 29-19 as we get ready to continue play. For Verona, 19 points, only three guys scored. And only one guy scored more than once. Cameron Williams had 15 of the 19 in the first half for Kertrell Robinson's Wildcats, Dennis.
Yeah, phenomenal first half. And defensively as well, he was doing a pretty good job on Evan Anderson, held him to 5 points in the first half.
29 points for Onalaska. Six guys scored for them in the first half. Here we go. Verona will start with the basketball, now working from our left to our right in their white jerseys, white pants. Here's a wide open three-point look to kick things off. Good for Mason Sherry. Dennis, we haven't seen any of Aiden Chapman yet for Verona, who played a lot last night, started last night for the Wildcats. Wonder why that is.
Not sure what's up there.
Here's a three-point attempt the other way. No good from Isaac Skemp. Rebound by Cameron Williams, who speeds across the 10-second line. Kicks to the left corner for Sherry. Drives the baseline. Spins. Back top of the key now for Bennett Buss. Buss gives it to Drew Murphy on the right wing, working against Kowal. Murphy floats one off the glass. Up and good. 4 points for him now. Just one bucket in that first half. Came into this tournament, Dennis, averaging over 25 points per game. Have to get him going if you want to get back in this one. Only a five-point game now, 29-24. Kowal drives, no good. Offensive rebound by Anderson, knocked away by Williams, but a foul called. We'll go against Cameron Williams. That's his second. And we'll put Evan Anderson at the line, shooting two. First one good from Anderson. First Onalaska point of the second half, just over a minute in.
2 for 15. Hey, watch the zone. Watch the 1-2-2. 32X. Body out.
Second no good off the back of the rim. Rebound, Mason Sherry of Verona. Buss will bring it up for the Wildcats, right side of the floor. 1-2-2 zone, it looks like, for Onalaska on defense as Williams drives the baseline. Bounce pass to the right corner, tipped out of bounds by Onalaska. Will stay with Verona. Not quite a box and one.
No, they're keeping Williams on Anderson. He's he'll be dogging him on the other side, but right. Anderson just kind of floating.
And one for Trey Poteet. Drives the baseline up and good. His first bucket of this one. Pulls the Wildcats within four with the free throw. Can make it a one possession game just like that. 10-point game at half.
Yeah, kept him quiet in the first half.
Really good start for Verona out of the locker room. Poteet, at the line. Shoots and makes. Nothing but net for Trey Poteet, the football star. Only his third game of the year here, basketball season. Dealt with an illness early on in the regular season. Made a season debut earlier on in the week against Janesville Parker. The game in which a raccoon, infested their bus. Had to cancel the JV games. 3-point game, 30-27. Anderson drives, fades away. What a shot by the South Dakota commit. Evan Anderson got it to fall. And for whatever reason, Verona lost the ball. It's gonna go back to Onalaska underneath their own basket. I missed the inbound. There was no defenders there. I don't know what happened.
Think he stepped over the end line. Must two officials were talking there.
Hands up. Nothing easy. Champ, coming to you. Drew, coming to you.
Here's the inbound.
Rotate.
Oh, my goodness. Skifton was tiptoeing the center court line, went behind the back, and this ball's still live for Onalaska. Here's a corner look for Skemp. Up. Rattles out. No good. Offensive rebound by Kowal. Back to Skemp now on the left wing for Anderson. Anderson dribbling with the left hand. Pivots at the left block. Back top of the key now for Skemp. Crosses over. Working against Sherry. Now back left side.
Murphy now on Anderson.
Anderson working the baseline against Murphy as Dennis points out. Back top of the key. Skemp for three. No. Rattles out.
Again.
Again an offensive rebound though by Chenault. And a foul called in the middle of the lane.
Foul on number three.
Pete picks up his first. Team second. Great offensive rebounding here. You don't get too often you get rebounds on back-to-back three-point misses.
Inbound for Skifton underneath their own basket. Anderson catches left wing, turns around, fades away from the free throw line. No good. Rebound by Mason Sherry of Verona. Stremlo will bring it up, kicks it forward to Cameron Williams. Oh. Euro step past to Sherry. Ball got knocked loose and a whistle blown. Just want to let our radio listeners know, 100.5 ESPN. We're with you for about another 10 minutes, leading you into coverage of Pistons Bucks. And you can watch us on the Madison College video stream. Visit their website, MadisonCollegeRecreation.com, for more information. Small fee to watch the rest of this tournament, but you're going to want to see those last two games, the championship game between Wisconsin Lutheran and Lakeville North, and the showcase game against Lake Mills and Wanakee later today here at Madison College.
Noah Sherry just drives. Picked up his third foul in that last series. And he'll get an offensive foul on this end. And that one looks like Mason Sherry.
Tough inbound for Onalaska, able to finally get rid of it. Anderson catches it right in front of us here, left side of the floor. Anderson will cross over to center court, past the 10-second line. Working against Mason Sherry. Anderson on the right wing, hands to Chenault. Still in the game with three fouls. Chenault will work with the left hand to the left side of the floor, now spins on the left wing. Bounce pass right corner, Kowal. Back top of the key now for Skifton, back left side, Chenault. Chenault will pop left wing, no good. Rebound by Stremlo of Verona. And back to Wildcats, way we go. Cameron Williams, coast to coast, blocked away by Skifton. Nice drive by Williams, but unable to make the shot is Cameron Williams. 15 first half points. Pop shot for Anderson, good from outside. Evan Anderson extends his lead back to 8. 14 and a half minutes to go.
You hear Control Robinson saying, rotate, rotate. They found an open look. Good ball reversal, open three.
Williams really wants the ball. You heard that clap. That was Williams calling for the ball. Back to Sherry, right wing. Three is up, no good. Shot it long. Mason Sherry has struggled with his outside shot in this one.
Yeah, calling a few more fouls here.
And a whistle blown with 14-10 to play. It goes against Verona's Maddox Bodeo. For 50 years, Zimbricon has provided the Madison area with quality Honda vehicles. The trusted staff of Zimbricon's used car dealership will save you time and reduce your car buying stress by finding the vehicle that matches your style. If you're in the market for a new Honda or a used Honda, visit Zimbricon in Madison today. Head to Zimbricon.com to search current inventory. 8-point Onalaska lead.
Murphy and Buss got a quick blow and get back in, and Poteet now out a little rust. First game was Wednesday after he'd been out with an illness. Wasn't sure what his stamina would be like, but he looks pretty good here for the back-to-back days.
Anderson crosses over at the free throw line, tries the outlet pass to Chenault. Picked up by Kowal right in front of his own bench. And now Skemp will drive from the left corner. Skemp's floater no good. Rebound Verona. Buss brings it up.
Hustle rebound there by Stremlo saving the ball.
Murphy fakes the shot on the left wing, now drives back outside for Buss, an open look, no good. Rebound by Anderson of the Hilltoppers. Here comes Onalaska in transition. Anderson works it on the right wing. Splits two defenders, fades away at the right elbow, got it to fall. Evan Anderson, the South Dakota commit, has found his groove in the second half. He has every point in the second half for Onalaska. All eight of them. About 5 minutes into the second half. Murphy on the left wing. Kicks to Sherry on the right wing. Sherry takes the step, now gives to Stremlo left side, now to Murphy in the corner, left corner. He'll drive the baseline, fades away after two steps. Rattles out, no good. Rebound by Chenault to Von Alaska. Hilltoppers three on two in transition. Oh. Chenault straight to the rack. And another charge called. Guess who drew it? Will Stremlo, but he's hurting after that one.
On the back, yeah.
Fell hard.
Back. A little delayed call there. Chestnut, boy, he put his shoulder down, just drilled Stremlo, came lipping off the court.
Chenault just picked up his fourth foul as well, something to keep an eye on for Von Alaska. The junior guard, averaging about 8 points per game at six in the first half, just drew his fourth foul with 12 minutes and 50 seconds to play. 10-point game, Von Alaska 37, Verona 27.
I'll tell you what, my all-Madden team is right. Stremlo is the captain today.
Yeah, no doubt.
Taking more charges than anybody else combined.
Gritty freshman. Williams bounce pass to Bridges Miller in the short corner right side of the floor. Cross pass left side, now top of the key. Murphy for three, got it to go.
Look out, they're coming.
Leads down to seven, 37-30 on Alaska in front of Verona. After that, Drew Murphy triple. Anderson, right side of the floor, looks for a screen, goes behind the back, now we'll work it down the baseline. Goes up strong off the glass, up and in for Evan Anderson. Wow. Has all 10 second half points for Von Alaska. Does the South Dakota commit, Evan Anderson. Williams gets the offensive board for Verona, no good. Bridges Miller underneath though, up and one for Kamar Bridges Miller.
Offensive rebounding every time.
What a play there. Off a not-so-great shot from Cameron Williams. Kamar Bridges-Miller there to grab the air ball. Maybe we'll just call it a pass. Goes up and in on the left side of the floor, looking to add another one. Leads down to seven, 39-32. Could make it six with the free throw. Hey, GRB Academy is baseball for the serious player. GRB Academy wants to be part of your plan to reach your potential. Utilize GRB Academy's 52,000-square-foot facility, 14 batting cages, and 6,000-square-foot weight room. Learn more at grbacademy.com. Free throw no good from Kamar Bridges-Miller. Lead remains 7 for Von Alaska, 39-32, just under 12 minutes to play. Smith passes inside to a cutting Skemp, and a foul called underneath four Wildcats, a random in the paint. And that foul goes against Cameron Williams, picks up his third with 11:42 to play. Need him on the floor, given what he's been able to give you offensively and defensively. All 15 of his points came in the first half. Skemp shooting two now. First one's up, nothing but net, all good for Isaac Skemp. Up to 8 points for him. He had 24 in a semifinal to lead the way for Von Alaska yesterday.
Two threes early, but he's been quiet from the field the rest of the way.
Second free throw from Skemp, up and off the right side of the rim, no good. Bus will bring it up for Verona. Works it right side of the floor. Pass to the corner for Murphy, back to Bus, high above the arc. Left side of the floor now for Cameron Williams, back to Murphy, top of the key, now left side for Bodeo. Bodeo spins, he's blocked away, picked up by Von Alaska. Skemp steals it away.
That was a foul missed.
I tend to agree.
You got a piece of him.
But we wear headsets and not whistles for a reason, bud.
Yep, that's right.
In the right corner, here's a triple attempt for Mitchell. Brody Mitchell's first shot of the game. No good. Rebound by Cameron Williams, who speeds the other way. Top of the key, works it with the left hand, kicks right side for Bennett Buss, now right corner for Bodea. Bodea holds it high over his head, gives it up to Murphy, now right wing. Left side of the floor now for Williams. Williams stumbles over his own feet as he brings it down the lone, lost the ball, turned over, back to Von Alaska. Skemple drive up left side, another charge called by Von Alaska. The fourth charge call this game against Von Alaska. Isaac Skemp's first.
That one might be a little suspect. I don't know if he quite got set there. And just on the contact, we'll write down. But they're calling him. That's the point of emphasis. The last game it was travels. We had multiple travels. Now we're picking up the turnovers here.
Here's a drive by Bennett Buss at the left block. Bounce pass outside for Bodeo. Top of the key now Murphy. Works it with the right hand into the lane. Kicks it back outside. Williams spins at the free throw line. Spins, fades away off the front of the rim. No good. Fights for his offensive rebound though. Jump stop step at the right block. Again, misses, but another offensive rebound for Verona, and a timeout taken by Cottrell Robinson and the Wildcats. It's Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania. 10-14 to play in the consolation game. 8-point on Alaska lead. We will send you off to Bucks coverage after I tell you one final time about Zimbrick Honda. For nearly 50 years, actually over 50 years at this point, Zimbrick Honda has provided the Madison area with quality Honda vehicles. The trusted staff of Zimbrick Honda's used car dealership will save you time and reduce your car buying stress by finding the vehicle that matches your style. If you're in the market for a new Honda or a used Honda, visit Zimbrick Honda in Madison today or head to ZimbrickHonda.com to search current inventory. The Detroit Pistons are 2-23 on the season. The Milwaukee Bucks 17-7. The Bucks favored by 18 points in this star-studded matchup. Coming up next on the 100.5 ESPN dial, we'll stay with you on the ESPN Madison video stream. Bucks Pistons up next right here on 100.5 ESPN.
Hey everyone, Molly Brown from ESPN Madison here for the best Southwestern food in the Madison area.
All right, we're sticking with you here on the video stream. 10 minutes, 14 seconds to play, and we can relax a little bit, Dennis. We're calling TV now, no more radio for us. 40-32 your score in this consolation matchup between Onalaska and Verona. Alongside Dennis Semra, I'm Alex Strofe with you here courtside at Madison College.
The walking Warriors back in the game. Will Stremlo, after taking some shots here. Last one drawing the charge and landed on his back. Came limping off the court, but there he is.
Murphy will drive. And ball goes out of bounds. We'll stay with Verona.
Need to get Murphy on track here. He's got 7-5 in the second half. But they make him work. Not got an untested shot yet today.
Here's the inbound for Verona. Kamar Bridges-Miller high above the key. Works it right side to Bennett Buss. Steps outside, now back inside the arc. Drives the baseline, bounce pass inside to Kamar Bridges-Miller. Bennett Buss now underneath, goes up right side. That bucket no good. Another offensive rebound as Kamar Bridges-Miller gets high up there, misses the follow-up, and eventually pulled away by Onalaska with 9:36 to play. 40-32 the score. Onalaska in front. A foul on Kamar Bridges-Miller. That's his third.
Verona foul on number zero. Kamar Bridges-Miller, his third.
All right, I got to admit my mistakes on the radio side. Premature goodbye. We're staying with you through the end of this game. I thought we were done at 4:30. So welcome back, radio audience. 40-32 and 9:27 to play. Colin Russo back at the Everlight Solar Studio. He's a little frustrated with me. Sorry, Colin, that's on me. I thought we were done at 4:30. 40-32, another foul called. That's the fourth now on Kamar Bridges-Miller, that time on the defensive side.
Back-to-back fouls, and now in the bonus. The rest of the way, last 9:27.
The Wisconsin Badgers brought their whole team today, it looks like. Kamari McGee's here, Nolan Winter's here, Jack Janicki's here, Tyler Wall's here, Chucky Hepburn's here. Assistant coaches Sharif Chambliss and Dean Oliver are here. Getting ready to watch future Badger Jack Robinson in the 6-8 championship game coming up next. Free throw this time from Evan Anderson, up no good.
Ah, that's rare. 84% free throw shooter. He's one of three today. And missed them both.
Missed them both. Back the other way for Verona, trailing by eight, top of the key, Sherry goes inside for Buss on the left block, can't contain it, throws it off the leg of an Onalaska defender, heads up play there by the point guard, Bennett Buss.
In the land of the Giants, point guard hanging in there.
Something like that.
He is a feisty point guard, I love him.
Sure is.
Just diving for loose balls. Dad Allen was a longtime coach there, older brother played ball here.
Murphy gets the inbound right near center court. He'll go behind the back, works it to the center side of the floor. Stremlo will pull a three from the right wing. Got it to go. Will Stremlo, the freshman with his first bucket of the night, had 4 points yesterday. How about a triple to pull the Wildcats within five? 40-35. Bounce pass to the corner. Kicks it right side. Now top of the key, Skemp for Onalaskan. Out of the corner for Skifton. Skifton drives with the left hand back outside. Skemp will pull a triple. Short off the front of the rim. Offensive rebound by Mitchell. Pump fake. And a fadeaway left side. No good. Again, another offensive rebound for Onalaskan. Skemp goes up with it underneath. Got his own miss. And then he's fouled. What a turn of events that was.
That is persistence, and Kertrell Robinson beside himself over here. Somebody grab the ball. And Mason Cherry picks up his third foul.
Couple subs. Free throw good that time from Isaac Skemp. His first free throw, or second free throw rather, of this second half, up to 9 points for him. 41-35 to score, 8.5 minutes to play.
Clank.
Rebound, Trey Poteet. Poteet brings it up, hands off to Bennett Buss on the right wing. Buss brings it top of the key, kicks left corner for Stremlo. Stremlo dribbles right hand, top of the key. Now to Poteet on the right wing. Poteet stops at the free throw line, kicks outside to Bodeo. Back inside Poteet, lost the ball, able to keep it in bounds, but they'll set things back up top of the key for Bodeo. Now left corner for Williams. Williams drives the baseline. Fakes the shot, bounce pass, double bounce pass. Now right side to Stremlo for three. No good, offensive rebound. Williams goes up left side, up and in for Cameron Williams. His first bucket of the second half. 17 total for him. 4 point game, 41-37. As Skemp drives and he is fouled in transition.
Throwing a foul on number 11, Bennett Buss. Shooting for Onalaskan.
It was against Bennett Buss, Dennis. It's his first foul.
Picks up his, and back to the line goes Skemp.
Yeah, he's getting comfortable there. Should get a cot or something. He's been there. Makes the first.
Well, he's mismade, made miss, made miss, made. We'll see what this one is.
Second one up, second one good for Isaac Skemp. Lead back to six for Onalaskan.
And nothing that a couple threes can't erase.
How about Bennett Buss pulls up a long 2-point shot, good for him. His first bucket of this one. Pulls the Wildcats within four once again.
There's that Cameron Williams defense again. Force that turnover.
Back the other way. Stremlo's layup. No good. Offensive rebound by Cameron Williams. Ball poked away. We've got a skirmish on the floor and a jump ball called as Trey Poteet got tied up with Chenault.
Poteet with a fumble recovery on that play.
Exactly. Still a 4-point game and a timeout on the floor. 43-39. Oh boy, t-shirt toss, Dennis. Wave your hands, Dennis. Who wants a t-shirt, Dennis? I want a t-shirt. We want t-shirts. Right here, Dennis wants a t-shirt. Dennis wants a t-shirt, right here. Dennis wants a t-shirt. Showing off the arm power deep.
They're not gonna give us one here, front row.
Unbelievable.
The cannon they have at the games. One of our stat people got hit one. That was a ricochet and got hit. She
How'd
doesn't
that
like
one feel?
Them anymore. Nah, it'll sting a little bit.
I bet. Close proximity. 43-39, 7 minutes, 15 seconds to play in this 608 basketball tournament consolation game. A reminder to stick with us. The championship game coming up next between Wisconsin Lutheran and Lakeville North. Although our radio listeners get Bucks Pistons. Two wins on the season for the Pistons, Dennis.
Just two?
2-23 on the year.
You get lucky once in a while. That's awful. Yeah, who'd the Lakers lose to the other night? And who had only three wins?
I got to be honest, I have no idea.
Yeah, I'm not. I'm so wrapped up in the college and the high school right now.
Me too.
Have a fantasy draft for the NBA, and after a couple of weeks, just make sure my guys are in the lineup and worry more about the Badgers and the local high schools.
All right, Verona basketball, they trail by four as they'll inbound underneath their own basket. Cameron Williams in the corner will pop up a three. Goes off the backside of the rim. Poteet gets up there for the offensive rebound. Takes one dribble, goes up with it strong, and is fouled on the way up. Troy Poteet will go to the charity stripe.
I lost the ball on number five, Brody Mitchell.
It's his second, team six. Poteet, nice rebound there. Fought, tried the tip, little tip, a little far off for that tip. Then just grabbed it. That was the best thing to do.
Poteet's first one good. This is a one-possession game all of a sudden. 43-40 with 7:05 to play. Can make it a two-point game. Second from Poteet up, and that is good. Two-point game. Here we go, Dennis. Buckle up.
Making a run.
43-41 on Alaska leads. Full court press now on for Verona. Poteet defending tightly, and they get it over the 10-second line in transition. Tipped out of bounds. We'll stay with on Alaska underneath their own basket.
What did they say earlier? First team to 50 is going to get this one?
I think that's going to prove true.
Murphy back in, Drew.
Bodeo out for Verona as Drew Murphy back in. Only 7 points for Drew Murphy in this one. He's got to pick it up here in the last 7 minutes if Verona wants to win this one. Inbound. Skemp catches right corner. Top of the key now for Mitchell. Goes left side. Skift in now to Anderson. Evan Anderson working against Cameron Williams. What a matchup this has been all night. Still holding. Now hands to Skifton near center court, right on that Wolf decal at center court. Now to Kowal on the right wing. Picks up his dribble. Bounce pass underneath. Nice find to Anderson. Left block. No good. Williams there in defense. Gets his own rebound twice in a row, and finally it falls for Evan Anderson.
Third time's the charm there. That's one way to pad your rebound totals.
Back the other way, Will Stremlo in transition with a quick layup. Still a two-point game, 45-43. Anderson still in the back half of the court, and a timeout call. Full timeout. We're on Alaska with 6 minutes and 6 seconds to play in this two-point ball game in this consolation third-place game. Wow, what a game. What a roaring comeback by Verona. Dennis Semrau, Alex Drew with you. We'll take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zipper Conda's presentation of Prep Mania in the 608 basketball tournament.
The GRB Rays have established themselves as one of the top baseball programs in the Midwest and the country. GRB Academy offers training programs for players of all ages and skill levels. Learn from some of the best baseball coaches in the area and find the program that fits your training goals and your schedule. Spots are filling up fast, so visit grbacademy.com to sign up now. That's grbacademy.com. GRB Academy, baseball for the serious player.
This is the 608 basketball tournament on ESPN Madison and Wisconsin On Demand.
6 minutes, 6 seconds to play in the consolation game here at the 608 basketball tournament, third annual at Madison College. Between Verona and Onalaska. Onalaska leads by two, 45-43. They had a 10-point lead at the half, and it's down to two. Alongside the Dean of Area High School Sports, Dennis Semra, Alex Strofe on hand with you courtside.
We come down to the two leading scorers here. Evan Anderson averaging has got 17 points today, and Cameron Williams for Verona has got 17 points.
Anything you can do, I can do better.
There you go.
On Alaska inbound, right across from us here. The back half of the court. Mitchell will take it up, working against Bennett Buss. Still in the wrong half of the court. Now gets it across half court line. Will pass left side to Skifton. Now inside Anderson on the left block. Goes off his knee. Now he's outside the arc. Defended tightly by Cameron Williams. Top of the key, Mitchell. Mitchell will drive. Kicks right corner for Skifton. Skifton top of the key for Kowal. Now left side for Skemp. Skemp goes back to Anderson. 1 foot outside the arc, now he'll drive. Baseline, pops one up, and that'll fall for the South Dakota commit, Evan Anderson. 19 points for him right now, 14 in the second half. And how about a steal on the other end as him and Stremlo got tied up.
Been waiting here, Chenault, point guard for Onalaska, sitting here at the scores table ready to come back in. four fouls. Sturmlo picks up his first foul. Wow.
He's had a really nice game.
As many hits as he's taken, yeah.
Shooting two for Onalaska, number 14, Evan Anderson.
Anderson will shoot two here in the bonus. Double bonus.
Double the rest of the way.
That might help them with a four-point lead and 5:27 to go. Anderson's first, up and good.
Slipping back in for the Hilltoppers, number 13, Noah Chenault.
20 points now.
And make it 21. 16 in the second half for Evan Anderson. Lead back to 6 for Onalaska. 49-43. Bennett Buss for Verona in the corner. Kicks top of the key for Drew Murphy. Now left side, Stremlo dribbles inside the arc. Back out for Murphy, who pulls a triple from the right side of the floor. No good. Rebound. Kowal of Onalaska kicks it forward to Skifton. Tie up underneath. That one will go out of bounds.
Whoever points first.
Well, now we're going to have a little bit of a discussion. We'll stay with Onalaska.
Two Verona players pointing in the direction, and Kirchhoff saying white ball, and the only one that matters is the referee, and he gives it to Onalaska. In your college, you're going to make half the people happy and half the people unhappy.
That's very true. That's that profession for you. Here's the inbound. Kowal, top of the key, Chenault. Inside Anderson, right in the middle of the lane. Pump fakes, goes up strong left side, and he's fouled by Drew Murphy. It's his second. And guess who's back at the free throw line?
Yes.
Evan Anderson.
84% shooter coming in, and he started out kind of cold, 1 for 4, but made his last two, now 3 in a row. I don't know how you pile up points, get to the free throw line.
True that. Leads back to 7, make it 8 as he makes them both.
4 in a row now.
4 in a row. Unbelievable second half for Evan Anderson.
Money player.
Williams at the free throw line. Pump fakes, now kicks back out. Way up top as Bennett Buss will set things back up for Verona. Stremla goes right side. Murphy has a wide open look for 3 off the front of the rim, no good. Rebound for Onalaska. Kowal goes to Skemp. Skemp brings it over the half court line, kicks left corner, back to Skemp. He's blocked at the rim, and Drew Murphy going to be called for another foul. He didn't like that one. He thought that was clean. Trey Poteet will step back in for Verona as Murphy picks up his third foul.
Shooting for the Hilltoppers, number 3, Isaac Skemp.
Skemp at the line. He's made 4 free throws this second half as well. Could bring the lead back to double digits. First one up from Skemp and good. Makes it a 9-point lead, 52-43.
Slipping back in for Verona, number 3, Trey Poteet.
Out here. 10 of 15 from the line here in the second half. This is what's putting it away for him.
No doubt.
Making 11
and makes
16.
Them both. Yep. 10-point game once again. 53-43. 4.5 to go. Williams will drive. Goes up strong right side. Got it to fall. Cameron Williams up to 19 points now to lead the way for Verona. Inbound pass almost stolen away by Williams as Anderson will bring it up right in front of us. Speeds past us on the left side of the floor. Underneath now, Skemp goes up with it. Ball goes out of bounds.
A block. That looked like a block to me for Poteet.
I don't know that that was touched, and you can hear Cottrell Robinson asking, was it touched?
Poteet went straight up.
And Onalaska.
Sorry, there's no video here.
I'm sorry? Oh, no instant replay, you mean?
Yeah.
Because there is video. You remember, we are on a video stream. Ryan Wollersheim working hard behind us.
Replay, video replay is what I was trying to say.
Yeah. Okay, just making sure we're on the same page.
They won't let us. We can show it to them. Ryan would be more than happy to, right?
Yeah, if he knows how to do that. Ryan, you say yes? Okay. Good stuff, dude. Good stuff. 4:12 to play. 8-point game, 53-45 following the Cameron Williams layup. Kind of an awkward offensive possession there for Onalaska.
So what did he think of the call?
Ryan, did they touch it, yes or no? Ryan says no.
Okay.
So he disagrees with the officials here.
And here we got a coach talking to one of the officials.
Let's go. Get him out of the timeout. Let's go.
4:12 to play.
John Fullerton, official here doing the book. He's an official. Let's go. Let's go. Get him out there. You get a minute. You get, in this case, 30 seconds for the timeout. No time for argument.
On the inbound underneath, skipped and missed the layup. He was wide open. Trey Poteet got the rebound. He's going to use his speed here. All the way up the court, kicks the left corner for Cameron Williams. Williams three, no good. Offensive rebound for Murphy, who goes back up. Got it to go. Nice bucket by Drew Murphy, the stud junior for this Wildcat team. 6-point lead for Onalaska, who has the basketball. 53-47, under 4 minutes to play. Chenault brings it up. Remember, he has four fouls. Something to keep an eye on. Top of the key, Anderson. Works against Williams, a 3.5 to play. And a foul called against Cameron Williams. That's his fourth.
Yeah, Chenault was on the bench quite a long time with that fourth foul, and team picked it up for him, able to attack the rim and get to the free throw line and kind of get that lead. Now they got him back in, their playmaker, kind of keep things under control here down the stretch.
Here's the free throw from Anderson, up and good. It's 5 in a row from the line for him. 5 points in a row from the line. And 5 makes, for what it's worth. Extends the lead to 7, 54-47. And he'll extend it to 8. 6 makes from the line in a row for Evan Anderson, headed to South Dakota next year. Unbelievable second half for him.
20. That was 25.
Cameron Williams on the wing.
I think we know who the most valuable player of the consolation game is.
I think that's fair to say, as long as it finishes the way it's been. As a miss on the Verona side, goes back to the direction of Onalaska. Skemp gives it up to Anderson. Anderson dribbles with the left hand past the half court line. Puts his back to Poteet and gets rid of it to Skemp left side. 3 minutes to play. Skemp crosses over, top of the key, working against Drew Murphy. Goes right side now for Chenault, who's guarded by Will Stremlin. Back to Anderson. And another foul called. A reach in there by Trey Poteet.
Verona foul on number 3, Trey Poteet.
It's his second. And we are a reminder in the double bonus. So guess what, Dennis? Evan Anderson looking to continue this free throw stretch. 6 makes in a row for him from the line. Here's number 7. Nothing but net.
It took him a little while to get used to the rims, I think, on the line. But he's been pure on every one.
Could extend the lead to 10 here on an 8th free throw make in a row. And guess what, Dennis? He made it.
Yes.
8 free throws in a row. Makes it a 10-point Onalaska lead. 2:45 to go. Pass to Poteet, right wing. Stops at the free throw line. Looking for an outlet pass. Gets Stremlo, top of the key behind him. Now to Murphy, left side. Back to Stremlo. He'll take one step and pop it. Got it to go. Nice shot by the freshman, Will Stremlo. 8 points in all in the second half for the freshman, Will Stremlo. Chip off the old block, I believe Dennis called him earlier.
This is a coming out party here. Played some minutes early, but he's going to earn a lot more.
He's looked good.
He was the first player off the bench today.
Skemp holds, defended by Stremlo, about 4 feet above the key. Now right side for Anderson, who's defended by Cameron Williams. Williams done a really nice job on him. You just can't really guard free throws. Anderson works it, left corner now for
just moving the ball. Playing their own version of four corners. No shot clock. This is what you can do. This is why you need a shot clock right here.
Anderson trips and he's fouled. Will that go against Williams or Poteet, though, is the question. It'll go against Trey Poteet. That's his third. And back to the line for Evan Anderson. He's 8 of his last 8.
Shooting for the Hilltoppers, number 14, Evan Anderson.
Shot is up. That's 9 in a row from the line.
92 seconds to play. It's an 8-point Onalaska lead. Anderson can make it 9 here.
This is a guy you do not want to play horse with.
Yeah, no kidding.
He's just going to kill you.
And rattles that one in. That's 10 in a row from the free throw line. Wow.
There's
a three-pointer on the other end for Buss. And Williams throws it off the leg of an Onalaska defender. Will stay with the Wildcats with a minute 21 to go.
Couple threes, get hot, some stops on the other end.
Inbound from Buss to Stremlo, top of the key. Left side, Murphy with a long three off the front of the rim, no good. Offensive rebound, Poteet. Poteet will work it inside, stops in the middle of the lane, and he is fouled on the way up. That foul goes against Adam Skipton, his second.
The foul on number 10, Adam Skipton, shooting for Verona, number 3, Trey Poteet.
Free throw from Poteet up and good. His fourth free throw of the second half. All 6 of his points have come in the second half. Cuts the lead to 8. Second shot from Poteet, also good. Money from the line for Trey Poteet. And a timeout called for Verona with a minute 11 to play in this 7-point ball game. 59-52 on Onalaska in front of Verona. I'll tell you what, Dennis, stars are out today at the 6-way basketball tournament. We mentioned the entire practically Badgers basketball team and staff is here. How about Badger basketball alum Josh Gosser in the house?
Awesome.
Lots to see in this championship game.
Port Washington High School grad.
Wisconsin Lutheran. First Lakeville North in the championship game coming up next.
First time I saw Josh Gosser was in a tournament. Port Washington was playing at Middleton. It wasn't a championship one like this one. It was just 2 games in 2 days. And junior year looked the part.
Yeah.
Just like, I like this guy. And he was the first Badger, you know, to get a triple-double school history.
Really?
At Northwestern.
That's why he's the dean of area sports.
Then the second one, I was actually on the scores table for that one. It was at Madison.
Onalaska to inbound against this full court press from Verona. Anderson catches it, gets rid of it. Skemp kicks it forward to Skifton. 2-on-1 now for Onalaska. Back to Skemp with a minute to play. 7-point game. Skemp and fire called it. Foul him. With 55 seconds, Skemp gets fouled. That'll go against Drew Murphy.
The universal word. As a youth coach, the first thing you teach your kids, fire means foul. Because if you yell foul, that's a technical. And he's that, and they fouled right away.
Isaac Skemp at the line. He's got 13. All 6 of his second half points, make it 7 of his second half points, have come from the free throw line as he knocks home the first. 14 overall now for Isaac Skemp. He's had a really good tournament for Onalaska. 24 in the semifinal yesterday, now 15 in this one. Makes all 8 of his free throws in the second half. Bounce pass to Williams in the corner. 9-point deficit for Verona. Williams drives, puts up the layup, misses it.
Good shot.
47 even on the clock. 47 even.
And the foul will go against Ian Cowell.
Ian Cowell shooting for
Is that his first?
First. Wow.
Just making sure I had that right. It's Cameron Williams. We'll shoot 2. First one's up from Williams. First one good. He's got 20 points overall now to lead the way for Verona. Second from Williams, up and no good. Rattles out, rebound on Onalaska. Skemp spinning. Full court press on again. He called the timeout as he fell to the floor. But are they going to give him the timeout? Are they going to give him the foul? They will give them the Onalaska timeout with 40.4 seconds to play. 8-point game.
Clemo Verona, 36.
Well, Dennis, what do you think?
It's got to be a full.
That's what you think?
Yeah, I'm just listening to the referee. They're arguing back and forth. No. That's got to be a full.
I'm like, hey, Dennis, what do you think of this great tournament we've seen so far? It's got to be a full timeout. It's got to be a full timeout.
It's interesting to watch. When you got a guy on the scores table that really takes charge, it's an official, it's kind of fun to watch. So, sorry, got a little distracted. I knew this was going to be a good matchup from last night, and it has been. A lot less physical in the second half. They've called a lot more fouls. I think
that
it was just too much in the first half. But the takeaway from this one is, yes, Onalaska can shoot free throws. Do not get into a free throw or a three-point shooting contest with them. And Verona, I'll tell you, as many shots as they got in the paint, their offensive rebound was relentless. They just got to finish. If they have those shots go in, they'd be winning this game right now. And then the player that's emerged, Will Stremlo by far.
Yep.
Kid's taking some shots and keep coming back for more.
I would say a couple kids from Verona have emerged. Cameron Williams, too.
Williams in the two games has just been phenomenal.
And they couldn't get the inbound off, could Onalaska. They just took another timeout. I thought you said they were out.
No, they were out of 30s.
Yeah. So another full timeout will be taken by Onalaska. Nice press by Verona, forcing two timeouts in a row. So still 40.4.
Even a game like this where you're not winning, there's a lot of things that Verona's doing right. They're pressuring the ball. They're having a foul when they have to. They're doing things the coach wants them to do. Their offensive rebounding has been pretty good. Three-point shooting, not so. And then their follow-ups, they just have not been able to finish in the paint today. But this is a team that, I mean, this is why you play better teams. That doesn't matter if you win by 20, 30. It's these games that you lose close or that you go down to the wire. It's going to help you in the postseason. And when it becomes a 0-0 season and winner plays, loser goes home. These guys will be battle-tested. And this is a strong junior team. There's only two seniors on this Verona roster. And again, Cottrell's second season, so they're learning his system, learning the players in the system. And I think it's a very good match here.
All right, here's the inbound for Onalaska. Skemp gets it forward to Skifton, and he is fouled by Stremlo with 33.3.
Good press break. Good job, Onalaska, passing the ball.
Shooting for the Hilltoppers, number 10, Adam Skifton.
Well, now it's Skifton's turn. He said, well, you know, Skemp and Anderson were living at the line. Give me a couple.
Skifton got it to go the first one. 4 points in the first half for him. First bucket of the second half. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. You're listening to the 608 Basketball Tournament.
Hey, this is Eric Name of The Athletic. You're listening to Madison's home of the Bucks, 100.5 ESPN, WTLX Monona, Madison, a Good Karma Brands radio station.
Skifton makes the second free throw and back the other way. Drew Murphy travels on his way to a fadeaway shot. Ball goes back down Alaska with 27.5 seconds to play and a 10-point lead. Skifton to inbound for the Hilltoppers. Gets it in to Anderson, who is quickly wrapped up and fouled. I believe that'll go against Cameron Williams, and that would be his fifth if it does.
It'll
go against Stremlo.
Yeah, he was smiling.
Will Stremlo.
His third.
And back to the line we go for Evan Anderson. If you're just joining us, Evan Anderson, a South Dakota commit, has shot 10 free throws in the second half. How many has he made?
Something tells me the last game today is not going to start on time with
throws. He missed one. His first miss. He made his last 10 from the free throw line.
11 of 15 at this point.
And is
they get it 12 of 16.
There he is. His 11th free throw make of the second half. Trey Poteet will speed it on to the Verona offensive side, trailing by 11. Outside, Stremlo thought about a three, gives it to Poteet on the right wing. Poteet tosses one up, he airballs it, and rebounded by Onalaska with 10 seconds to go. And a foul called with 6.8 left. That'll be Cameron Williams' fifth.
Verona foul on Cameron Williams.
Shooting for the Hilltoppers, number 13.
I've got him for 19 fouls in the second half.
My goodness.
Verona. Oh, you do what you got to do.
Tried to crawl back into this one, unable to. I should mention there is 6.8 seconds on the clock. The dot, the decimal in the middle of six kind of looks like a zero.
That's 608.
608, yeah. Anyway, first free throw good from Chenault. 7 points now for him. Azan Alaska will take third place in the third annual 608 basketball tournament. Second free throw up and good. Making a 13-point lead with 6.8 left. Poteet picks it up. He will drive. He will pull up top of the key. He will airball it. It will go out of bounds with 1.8 seconds left to play. And on Alaska, we'll get to inbound this to wrap it up. And that will do it. 66-53 on Alaska tops Verona. We'll take one final break. When we come back, we will wrap it up with the Stoughton Trailers final haul and preview the championship game, which you will only be able to watch on demand at MadisonCollegeRecreation.com. 66-53 on Alaska tops Verona in the consolation game. We'll wrap it up next. It's Zimmerconda's presentation of Prep Mania.
Working at a company that truly cares and invests in their employees should never be taken for granted. Work, learn, and earn at the Weld School at Stoughton Trailers. The program includes 1 week of paid training starting at $18 per hour and features small class sizes designed for individual attention. No prior experience is needed because teaching their employees is all part of the Stoughton Trailers way. Graduate into a full-time position in Stoughton or Evansville. Apply today at stojobs.com. That's stojobs.com.